Hey guys, this is Dr. Sangeeta and welcome back to another lecture of Dental Paathshala where we help you understand and learn dentistry better and easy way. And today's topic is the public health topic, which is the epidemiology. So epi means among, demi means people, and logy means study. So we are going to study on the preventive medicine. How do we prevent a disease? Nowadays we have the coronavirus. So how do we prevent this disease? For that, we have the epidemiology, which is the study. So we are studying. So this is the epidemiology. So without further ado, let's get started. So guys, before we get started, make sure you subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon so that you don't miss any of our future videos. So today's topic is epidemiology. First of all, why are we studying this epidemiology? Second question, what is epidemiology? Third thing, what does this epidemiology chapter will give us idea about? So what is this epidemiology about? The main question is that. Epidemiology, you can take out D out of epidemiology. So D means disease. We will be studying about the disease. Why are we studying this epidemiology? You can take example of the pandemic, which is right now is the COVID-19. So if we look at any particular disease, because see, COVID-19 is spreading worldwide and it has lot of impact on everybody's life, because we are on lockdown, the economy is down, so everything is getting affected because of this disease. So this is the reason that we have epidemiology chapter in our subject. Epidemiology means we are studying three D's in the epidemiology. So first D is the disease frequency. So how frequent is this disease? We will be studying further in this chapter that either this disease is occurring seasons to season, like in case of we can say influenza. So whenever there is a high humid environment, this occurs. So like that, there are certain diseases which occur mostly, like in that of upper respiratory tract infection, you can take. This mostly occurs in the winter seasons. So like that, we will be studying about how frequent a disease is. So how this disease is occurring, either it is occurring seasonal or this disease is coming after every two years this disease is coming. So like that, we are studying the frequency, how frequent this disease is. Second D is the distribution. So distribution is how this disease is distributed. Either it is only particularly related to the Wuhan or it is worldwide. So how this disease is distributed, that also we are studying. Third D is our determinant. So determinant is the factors. What are the factors which are related to this disease? That means it is spread in the people who are consuming the raw meat. So what are the factors, basically, if you can take for COVID, what are the factors which are related to this spread? So the factors, like if there is any unhygiene practices there, then the spread rate is higher. If there is any crowded place, then the rate is higher. So like that, whatever the factors are associated. I'm just giving you an example of COVID-19 for that, for the time being, so that you guys can understand it better. So basically, we are studying a disease. So what is epidemiology? The definition, which was well accepted definition, is by John M. Last in 1988. So it is the study of distribution and determinant of the health related states or the event. So any health related state or any event in a specified population, we are studying the distribution as well as the determinant and application of this study to control the health related problem. So why are we studying this epidemiology? We are studying this epidemiology so that we can prevent or we can cure the coronavirus. So that is the reason we are studying this epidemiology. So basically, in case of pandemics, like now COVID-19 is there, that case, in on all these cases, the epidemiology is very helpful in making us, in coming us, coming up with a treatment plan. So that, because we know that, how we know the nature, when we know the nature of the disease, of course we can come up with a cure or the prevention of that disease. And this is the reason, see, why this coronavirus is not infecting everyone, because when we know the nature of the disease, then we can at least prevent it. If not cure it, at least to prevent it. And this is about the community medicine, is that the community dentistry is, the public health dentistry is, that we are studying any disease so that we prevent it. At least not cure it, we want to prevent it. We don't want that every person in the family get infected. So that is the reason, until and unless we have the cure of particular disease, we have cure of particular health problem, at least we can prevent it. Either you take it, the health disease, so we can take less fatty food, or you can take healthy diet, or you can take more fibrous food. So that will also prevent the coronary heart diseases. So CHD. Or you take example of COVID-19. So that way, if you are sanitizing, so because we know the frequency, distribution and the determinants of the disease, that we can at least prevent this disease. So epidemiology is the study of distribution. If we are studying the distribution, we are studying the frequency, and we are studying the determinants. So we are studying three things. So there is three D's. The components of epidemiology are three D's. And because, why are we doing this? In order to control that particular health related problem. So we have the epidemiological triad in this. So as you can see, this epidemiological triad has three things. One is the agent, then the host, and then the environment. That means the agent, which is our pathogen. So this is the pathogen. So this is our, for example, influenza, we can see H1N1. So like that, in the COVID, we have the coronavirus. So coronavirus is the agent or the pathogen in this case. So this disease is occurring because of three things. Once, because of the pathogen. Without the coronavirus, there cannot be any coronavirus. The host, because the host susceptibility is low. See, coronavirus is not affecting every individual. I am just giving you an example of coronavirus so that you guys can understand better. So the host. Host, as you can see, whoever has got the low immunity, those are the target population or the target people for the COVID-19, right? So those who have the low immunity. So basically, the immunity of host also matters. And the third one is the environment. If there is the sanitized environment, if the environment is neat and clean, then also this disease is not occurring. So we are studying, so this epidemiological triad tells that disease occurs due to three things. One is the agent, because of the pathogen. Now, we'll be studying in epidemiology that the nature of the agent, the toxicity, how toxic it is, how virulent it is, and either it is susceptible to any antibiotic. And this is the reason that we have not got the cure of the coronavirus, because it is not effective with any of the antibiotics which are available with us, right? So we are studying the susceptibility of the antibiotic also. Also the ability of this pathogen, either it is a virus or it is a bacterial. So the pathogen, is it able to survive outside the body? So there were certain rumors about it that it will not survive outside the body. As you guys have been up to date by the news, I guess you guys all are watching the news channel and you guys are updated with the coronavirus. So that is the reason I'm taking, for each and everything I'm taking example of this, so that you guys can understand better. So agent, basically we are checking the ability of the agent to survive outside the body, if the agent is susceptible to any antibiotic, or if how virulent it is, how infective it is, how toxic it is. Also this will help us to eradicate the pathogen or to genetically modify it, which we are looking for the cure. Then coming to the host. So host is basically the host is the individual, right? So host is the person who is getting infected by the pathogen. So host is us, we human beings. So the age matters, because it is affecting the old age. So age also matters. So, and also if there is any prior exposure, suppose those who are infected with the coronavirus, they are not getting again the coronavirus, right? So the exposure also matters. Like how the chicken pox is there, like that. So susceptibility. If the patient susceptibility or the immunity, that plays a very important role. either it is the HIV or it is coronavirus, those who have the low susceptibility, such as people who have diabetes, people who are suffering from medical condition, or who are at a senior age group, they are more susceptible for getting infected with the agent or with the pathogen. So immunity also plays a very important response. And see, though the things which can prevent from the disease, the host which can do to prevent from the disease is either to get immunized, but still we don't have any vaccine for coronavirus. So what we can do? We can take a good nutrition, or we can isolate. So how are we going to treat it if we get infected? We are going to isolate ourselves and we are going to have a good diet. So the interventions are treating, isolating, immunization, or a nutrient. And the very important thing is that education, which plays an important role, education, quarantine, so be it is any disease, so many infective, so many communicable disease, we need to quarantine ourselves. For example, in TB also, the earlier treatment, if you have heard of TB people, we used to isolate them, like at all, like quarantine, there was a quarantine time for TB patients also. So to educate or to quarantine, so these are the important factors. Then coming to the environment, if we talk about environment, see, the climatic changes, some disease are climate related. For example, we can say influenza virus. Some disease are related to some population density, so some have the physical structures. So intervention for the environment factor is that sanitation. If we are maintaining the sanitation, if we are keeping the environment clean, we are not getting the disease. The housing quality, if it is neat and clean and tidy, so the disease chances of getting the disease is less. And the preventive services, so if there is if there is any disinfectant, if the disinfectant is getting sprayed, so like that in the streets nowadays, as you can see, the people, the government is infecting the streets, disinfecting the streets. Disinfecting the streets. So like that, basically, the intervention is that educating, protecting, sanitizing. So if we are doing these three things, we are not letting the disease hamper us, right? So this epidemiological triad consists of the agent, host, and the environment. Now, when do you get the disease? See now, when do you get? Suppose I'm going to draw two things. Host, let's just write host here. Okay, so we have the environment first. This is the environment, right? Then we have the host, and then the agent. So when the agent, and at the constant environment conditions, so when the environment is stable, in that case, that when the agent and host are equal, that means the disease is, there are chances. If the host is bigger, host is at the this side, that means, and agent is less, that means there is no disease. But what happens when there is, the agent is overpowering the host, right? When the agent is overpowering the host, there is going to be chances of the disease. What happens when the immunity of the host is low? When the immunity of the host is low and the agent is overpowering us, so again the diagram goes same. So the immunity is low, then also there will be a disease. What happens when this environment only changes? When the environment is favorable for the agent, then also disease is there. What happens? Environment will be from green. What happens when the environment is such that it is hampering the host response? Host, immunity. So all these cases, there is going to be the disease. So basically, this disease is related to the time, place, person, we can say. So it is dependent on, so we will be studying the time distribution. Distribution is when it is occurring, to whom it is affecting, and which area it is affecting. So it is the distribution, which is the time, place and person, and the factors which are responsible for the particular disease, and also the what is the frequency of the disease. So how do we describe the disease? We are describing the disease in terms of time, when it is occurring. Like COVID-19, it occurred in 2019, right? So the time, the place, Wuhan, and the person who are eating raw meat. So this was the rumor, don't know. So now it is the occurrence and the distribution of the disease, we can say, is in terms of time, place and person. And this includes a collection of the data, collection and analysis of the data. So we are not saying it simply, once we have the statistics, once we have the data, once we collect the data, once we analyze the data, then and only then we talk about the distribution frequency of the particular disease. Then and only then we are going to describe the disease, right? So first thing is, we are describing a disease. So guys, I hope that you know this by now, that epidemiology is the science of preventing a disease. So epidemiology means epidemic. Epi means among. Epidemiology. So we will see epidemiology. Epi means among. Demo means people, and logy means study. So among the people, if there is occurrence of any disease, we are studying that disease is the epidemiology. So it is basically the science of preventive and the social medicine. What are the uses of epidemiology? So Moore is told that it is used to study historically. So from the past, we are studying the epidemiology, any disease. So like we went to Wuhan to study the COVID virus, right? So going back to the history to check the rise and fall of the disease. So historically we are going and we are studying the rise and the fall of disease in the population, also at the community diagnosis. See, at the community diagnosis, that means it is the identification as well as the quantification of the problem in a community. So in a community, we are identifying, we are checking the mortality rate, the morbidity rate. So also we are identifying the group or individual who are at the high risk for specific that particular disease. Suppose the old age, if we talk about example of COVID-19. So we are already telling the senior citizens always to put mask and not to go out, and to avoid going out as much as possible. So actually this is because of the study of epidemiology that we have come to a diagnosis. We have come to a community diagnosis because it is helping us to identify the individuals or the people or the group who are at the high risk, who are in the need of a healthcare. Also the planning and evaluation. So this epidemiological information, it tells about the distribution of the particular disease, either over a period of time as well as the place, so that it helps us in planning the prevention. Like if we talk about the coronavirus, so because after that we have studied the time, place, distribution, everything about the disease, the frequency. So once we have studied all that, then we have planned that we should keep all the people for quarantine, right? So that is the planning. So we, because of this study, we are planning that how a disease should be controlled or how disease should be prevented in case till then we don't have a cure. So since we don't have a cure for COVID-19, so we want to prevent it. And how do we prevent it? Until and unless we have the study, until and unless we have the causes, until and unless we know everything about the disease, then after we know about the disease, then we plan the prevention of the disease. Then we plan how do we prevent it. Then Narendra Modi, he planned the quarantine. So this is the planning as well as the evaluation of the disease in order to reduce the frequency of the disease. So next come the evaluation of the high risk. Individuals who are at the high risk and the chances. See, it is very important. Because once we know that the population which is at the high risk, and we evaluate the population at the high risk, we can decrease down the frequency of that particular disease. Then coming to completing the natural history of the disease. See, after that we complete the history of the disease, then we know that the pattern of the disease. We know that the pattern of the disease in a community, and we know the disease, is it related to any specific host, is it related to specific environment factor or the agent. So if once we know all of these things, then we know that about the disease. So once we complete the history of the disease, then we know which host it is going to affect, what is the agent of the disease, and also the environmental changes which can prevent the disease. For example, if we talk about the agent is the coronavirus, the host is the low immunity individuals, and the environment, if we sanitize the environment, if we make the environment clean, then we can also prevent the disease. So we know that if after getting the history of the disease, we know how to prevent a disease in a community level. Also searching for the causes as well as the risk factor. When we are doing this epidemiology, when we are studying any disease from the root base, so we know that we can identify the cause. And because, see, once we know that this is COVID-19 is from Wuhan, right? So we can go back in Wuhan and we can study what is the cause of the disease. What are the risk factor of the disease? Also, epidemiology help us to identify the causes as well as the risk factor of the disease. So these are the uses of the epidemiology given by Morris: the study of the disease, the risk and fall of the disease at the and community diagnosis, planning and evaluation. Evaluation, the people who are at high risk and high chances of getting the disease. Then the completing the history of the disease and causes and the risk factor of the disease. Next comes the terminology. There are certain terminology. So first one is the infection. Infection is basically any infectious agent when it goes inside the body and it multiplies. Suppose this is the COVID-19, coronavirus, right? So suppose this is the coronavirus. So once it goes inside the body and it multiplies, so that is the infection. It is the entry and the development or the multiplication of any infectious agent into the body. Either it can be man's body or animal's body. So that is the infection. Contamination is that when this infectious agent, it is present on any surface. So that is the reason we sanitize everything, because we want to decontaminate the coronavirus. So contamination is when this agent is present on any surface, not on our body, but also, see, body surface also, but also as well as the clothes or this whiteboard or this duster. So like that, if it is present on the body as well as on the surface, either it is present on my hair or it is present in water. So anything in which this infectious agent is present, that is contaminated. Then comes the in the host we have then again infectious disease. Now infectious disease, when this infection is occurring, is causing any disease. So it is causing any clinical symptoms, then it is known as the infectious disease. So basically it is the clinical manifestation of a disease. Either it can be in the man or animal due to the infection. So that is the infectious disease. Then comes the contagious disease. Contagious diseases, see, which is contagious, which is from contact. So cont, we can take from the term contact, which is from the contact. So contagious diseases transmitted through the contact. It can be the scabies, it can be the sexually transmitted disease, or it can be the coronavirus also. Then coming to communicable disease. Then communicable disease are the diseases, see, which are either directly transmitted from man to man, animal to animal, or from the environment. So these are a kind of infectious disease which can be transmitted, are known as communicable disease, which can communicate with us. So because disease can communicate with any of the medium, either it can be the direct transmission or it can be the indirect transmission. Then comes the epidemic. So epidemic is the widespread occurrence of the disease in a community at a particular time. So earlier this coronavirus was the epidemic in the Wuhan, But then it became pandemic when it got worldwide. So I guess now you guys know what is epidemic, what is pandemic. So epidemic is if any infectious disease is present in a community at a particular period of time. Like how coronavirus was there, since it was there, because now the news are coming that it was there by before the November also. So it was there in the November, it was there in the December. So that was, it was just in the Wuhan at that particular period of time was the epidemic. So if any infectious disease, it is the widespread actually. It is the outburst, because that was the outburst in the Wuhan city. So it is the outburst or the widespread occurrence of any infectious disease in a community at a particular period of time is the epidemic. Endemic. See, endemic is when this disease is, this infectious disease, it is constantly present in that particular area. That means if any certain disease is present in that particular area and which is not transported outside it. Such as we can say the common cold. So this is which is not transported to any other population, but this disease is present to that particular population, that particular region, that particular community from a long period of time. So the constantly presence of the disease or the infectious agent in a specific population, in a geographical area, which is not imported from outside. So that is present within themselves, that is not coming from any other source. So that is the endemic. Then comes the sporadic. So sporadic, as the word says, sporadic means scattered. So this is the occurrence of a disease. It is usually like from time to time. So this is like we can say polio. So it is separated in the space and the time, but there is no connection. This is scattered. So if you look at the world map, in the world, this disease is scattered. So in one particular area and one in another particular area. So this is a kind of irregularly scattered disease from time to time. And there is no connection between each other. That is, polio is not because this particular community has polio, so that is spreading to another community. No. There is no connection between them. So that is the sporadic disease. Then comes the pandemic, which is the coronavirus. WHO later declared COVID-19 as the pandemic virus. So pandemic, when it got affected in a large population of the world. So when it was occurring over a large geographic area, when an epidemic from a target population, when it spreads to worldwide, we can say is the pandemic. When from Wuhan, it is affecting so many countries. So that is the pandemic. Always pandemic, you can remember from the coronavirus. Epidemic from the Wuhan. So it is the outburst or it is the occurrence of in the widespread occurrence of a large portion of population all over the world, over the geographic area. Either it is the nation wise or it is a continent wise or it is the worldwide. So before coronavirus also there was the influenza, which was also from the China. So in 1918 and also in 1957 there was a pandemic which came from the China. So that was the influenza, now the coronavirus, COVID-19. So this is the pandemic. Then comes the exotic. Exotic means disease which are imported into the country and which otherwise it doesn't occur, but it is imported into the country is the exotic virus. Zoonosis, zoo as the word suggests. So it is a transmissible disease. It is transmitted. It is an infectious which is transmitted from the animal to men. So it can be the anthrax. It can be the tuberculosis, bovine tuberculosis. Then comes the epizootic. So epi means epidemic. Epidemic of infection which is coming from the animals. So like the anthrax came. Like the influenza came. Like the rabies. Or we can say if the coronavirus is coming from the bat, then it is corona also. But it is not 100% confirmed that it is coming from the bat. So we cannot tell that this is the epizootic, because it is some are saying that it is the synthetic virus, it is prepared in the laboratory, so we cannot see. So epizootic is basically an epidemic of such a disease which is occurring from the, which is coming from the animal population. So guys, type of epidemiology can be a descriptive epidemiology in which we are going to describe the study. Then there is an analytical epidemiology. In this we are going to study the risk factor. So in that we will study the case control, cohort study, all these studies. Then comes the experimental epidemiology, which includes the randomized control trial, the clinical trial or the community trial, all the trials, the experiments. So the epidemiology, the study design can be into three types categorized. Next video we are going to talk about the descriptive epidemiology. So we are going to describe the survey according to place, time and person and the case reports. So and next to that video will be the analytical and then the experimental epidemiology. So if you have enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up. And if you enjoy watching our channel, then subscribe to it if you haven't done it yet. Also, you can comment in the comment section below. And now in the description box below, there is a chance to support me on Paytm or PayPal to make free videos for you guys and to make free notes. So till then, take care, keep studying, keep learning. I'll see you soon, guys.